Hello, everybody. Welcome back to Redemption Reapers. The Hawk's Nest is under attack. Let's go defend it. If you continue on, you will no longer be able to skirmish in this area. Proceed to the next chapter. Oh, you mean these? Oh, yeah. I kind of forgot about those. Huh. I mean, is it even worth it to do this? I mean, I guess I could get a couple of ingots and stones. But I mean, you would probably just pay to have your weapons repaired if you were to do this. So I'm not exactly sure if you would actually come out on top money-wise. Anyway, we want to press on. Important business to attend. Oh no.
We have to get the survivors out of there.
Book. Okay. Yes, that is the big cheese. Clipped wings. Oh no. Oh, that doesn't sound good at all. Defend Naki while he escapes.
Those damn monsters. I'll kill them for this.
At this rate, the nest will be overrun.
They lured us away so they could launch a surprise attack.
Perhaps they're not the mindless beasts we took them for.
The nest, no. Please, not again. Hang in there, Naki. I'm here.
Berserker.
Captain. Leave this to us. You look after the boy.
Socius.
We have to dispatch the other Mork so Naki can escape.
We'll return to
the captain once he's clear.
These Mork play us for fools. And they'll die for it.
Eight movement.
Time goes short. Let's move.
Now, how to approach this?
Level 40, 250 HP, 35 attack. Are you kidding me? And even these guys are kinda tanky, but this dude, Harbinger. Oh lord. Oh lord, he coming. We got Slither Hounds. But yeah, completely new enemies here. Shadewalkers and Berserkers. Ooh, this is gonna be interesting. Oh, my lord.
Is that the best you can do?
Captain Rowan!
It seems my fate is sealed.
Uh-huh.
Be gone!
Sure does seem like a little bit. Oh, they can teleport as well. Oh, this is just wonderful. This is just absolutely wonderful. No, wait, they didn't move. They did. It's just such low accuracy.
Out of my way.
Nice crit though. Should we all go down the same path? I think so. And then spread up at the next intersection. Oh, they have basically no defense. Ah! Why would you attack again?
Got it in my sight.
I won't relent.
Taking the shot.
Does he follow Sarah around all the time?
Enough.
Right. Good dodge.
Your time has come.
I mean, it looks like these guys can dish out the damage, but they can't necessarily take it. Which, I mean, I guess makes sense for a berserker. Jambias? Jam-a-lam-a-ring-ding-dong? Yeah, there's actually no way to get to them. It's all blocked off. I mean, only 240 HP to go through, so we're only gonna be here another 120 turns until Rowan has beaten the Harbinger. Yeah, one swing from that sword and you're dust, dude. I kinda hate the fact that Glenn always lets him stand for like 1 HP. That is just, ugh. The worst. Oh no! You missed! Not supposed to miss, dude! Ah, No, you can't do the thingy thing anymore. Dang it. Oh, 50%. No.
Enough.
Here they come.
In come the doggos.
Give me all you got.
Okay, I'm gonna wait for one more turn, and then we can advance. Looks like they just blocks with his hand. How long can the old man, the lieutenant, keep this up, though? That's the question, isn't it? Poor dude has jumped the frame. Or is about to, I should say.
I'll hold them off.
Captain and Socius. There.
Don't worry. They can take care of themselves.
Dead. They have us surrounded as well.
Then we cut our way through.
Get moving. All of you.
Stay close to me. Right.
Oh. Auto. Got a bit of an incoming there. Question, if Rowan dies, does this guy come for me? I hope not.
Say good night.
shot.
Ready for more?
You'll never.
This should do it.
I don't think Aster, because she will attack again.
You're finished.
Yep.
It's not over yet.
Remember your training. I am.
Your time has come.
1 HP, man. Always the 1 HP. But Anarchy seems to always stay with Sarah, so gotta keep that in mind. I can go this way and somebody has to split up to get that chest. And we're making our way through this.
I'm not afraid.
Come on. I mean, I knew I used the daggers, but still. Come on.
Meet your demise.
Anything else to use at all? I'll be looking over there. 22. That's so toast, buddy. I hate to break it to you.
Enough.
I was gonna say that guy's a bit tankier than the others, but Glenn had nobody standing next to him, so he didn't get the attack damage buff. Guess I can't forget about that.
enough.
Did I make sure with these guys?
You're a danger.
Bring it on.
Throw in the Dodge King.
Be gone.
Oh, hello.
See you in hell.
Kill.
Steal yourself.
Sentinel stands almost feels like cheating, I gotta admit. It's so good.
I am
ready. Ooh. Oh.
Your time has come.
Ooh. Wow. Okay. The hell?
I'd hope to end this swiftly.
Glenn the Goat. All right, we're nearly out of this.
Our fight is here.
You're heading your way.
Bit farther. A lot of dogs, though. Come on, Roan. A bit more. Just a teeny tiny bit more. You could do it. I believe.
Meet you tomorrow.
Nice. can't not use Impaler.
Say goodnight.
Karen is just on treasure chest duty again.
Clear the way.
More strength on the big guy. Nice.
You're finished.
I hate that they're getting the level up this close to the end, but I guess it is what it is. Because, you know, obviously I wanted to use experience, but just a little bit of experience to push them over after a mission, but so like I can't do that later or anything. You getting tired yet? Another 98. Oof. Old man putting in good work. Prim ball.
Bring it on.
I guess I'm not killing the two dogs. I'm a generous god. Oh, no damage. Oh, that's not good.
I'm not.
Nice.
Just a little more.
Stay focused.
Silver ingot. Actually, do you guys have anything? Nah. Karen can make it to the exit or not, we'll have to fight them. Huh. I guess I can shoot them a little bit.
Taking the shot. Let's make this one count.
Played myself. More strength though. That's nice. The battlefield or eliminate all enemies. Oh. Well, I mean, they just kill that guy. Not that you've got the level up anyway. Don't know if 8 XP was worth 2 durability, but here we are. Blindsided. Yay, 20 turns, woo! Yes, I guess that is quite apt. Here we go.
So soon?
We have to go! Now!
We can't leave him!
Remember our creed.
Get off me, you idiot! I still have...
If you truly respect the captain, honor his final command.
Socius. Death is finally upon us.
Well, that was quite a turn of events there, wasn't it? Damn. Only gone, huh? Another good level for him. Damn. Oh boy. Not looking good, not looking good, I'm telling you. Can't get anything here. No. How much damage is he actually getting? Four. Okay, no skills. The yummiest. That's my critical rate, but a little bit less might. And more accuracy. Yeah, I think I'll just leave it like this for now. I need repairs. Movement. I think I kind of want that on Earth, I'm gonna lie. I mean, the accuracy hit is. God, it's only five. And one movement on him? Yeah. At least brings him in line with the others, except from Sarah. So he won't. I don't want to say dead weight, but be behind so much. Do we want to increase his faith? I mean, he's kind of susceptible to magic attacks, isn't he? Then again, the others aren't that much better off. Oh, God, I really should use these things. Especially this one. Yeah, this would have been great on Glenn, actually. So he could have killed all these guys and I'd leave them with one HP. Oh, yeah. Oh, really undecided, man. Yeah, still not gonna buy anything here. It's going to be a bit short on money. Oh, wait, I do have a silver ingot. I guess I'm gonna at least buy the upgrade material. Too undecided on these, and I guess I don't think he ever miss out on them. They will go out of stock, so leave it at that. Yum, Jambias. With a curve, these white daggers were some of the fangs of some ferocious beast. They were forged to be extraordinarily light, so much so that their weight is negligible in battle. Fighters armed with Jambias seem to dance on the breeze as they cut down their foes, earning these weapons the nickname of Windcutter Fangs. Brimball. The ringlet fills its owner with wanderlust. Stories claim it will illuminate a traveler's path while in moonlight, always guiding them true. All of its previous owners, even those who never cared for adventure, are said to have set off for distant deserts, the open sea, active volcanoes, and unexplored continents. The ring never led them astray, ensuring each and every one made it back from their journey with health intact. That's kind of nice. Oh, here we go. Berserker. Despite their size, berserkers can chase some prey with alarming speed. With four arms, allow them to strike twice, claiming the lives of foes that may have survived their first attack. The rust stained their blades speaks to the sheer volume of blood they have spilled. Shadewalker. Armed with sickles and wreathed in shadow, Shadewalkers look like the embodiments of death itself. They must be watched with great care, lest they seize on the moment of inattention to vanish and relocate in their victim's blind spot. A scarlet glow emanates from the center of their chests. This living light goes out only when the Shadewalker is run through with a blade. Champion. The Harbinger is never seen without the mort known as Champions by its side. Clad in imposing armor and brandishing brilliant azure spears, Champions have the ability to heighten the overall capabilities of nearby mort, whether it's due to an innate subtle intellect or their outward display of loyalty to the Harbinger is unknown. Their eyes gleam with a cold blue light. But if there is something, some meaning to this, none yet live who know it. Okay. So I guess we face these another time. I mean, it makes sense that they are like the bodyguards of the Harbinger, as he is known. Oh boy. All things certainly got more interesting, didn't they? Yes, they did. Yes, they did. Alright, everybody. I guess we all need a moment to recuperate from what just transpired here. And I guess things are taking a slight turn for the worse from now on. But we'll see. We will see. Well, that's this episode of Redemption Reapers, everybody. I hope to see you in the next one. Until then, bye-bye.